Welcome to the Forensics Detailing Channel. Today we're going to do a video on the one bucket wash method. Okay guys, so this is a subject area that the channel hasn't really gone into yet in any great detail, and that is kind of washing your car, you know, doing your maintenance wash. Now I'm here to kind of talk about a method that I use to wash my car. I'm calling it the one bucket wash method because it has one bucket basically. So as with anything, I'm still a fan of the kind of the traditional method, I should say, for cleaning your car with detailing, or the approved method that everyone seems to use, is the two bucket method, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. And I'm a fan of it. You know, there's a reason, there's a theory behind it, and that's all sound and all that reasoning. But I'm going to talk about why I generally, when I'm washing my cars, I will use a one bucket wash method. Okay. So to start with, what is the traditional way that someone who's into detailing will wash their car? First of all, they'll have free flowing water. So we're not talking about one of these waterless wash or rinseless wash systems that I've done, did a review on the other day. So this is a wash where you have free flowing water. So typically that wash will involve a pre-wash phase, like a snow foam or a citrus pre-wash or a traffic film remove, whatever you want to call it. And you'll deliver that onto your car first and rinse it off as a means of getting as much grime off contactlessly as you can before you move in with a method that involves making contact with the car, okay? So we're not doing any of that pre-wash. We're not using a pressure washer with this method. We'll talk about what we're gonna do a little bit later on. So no pre-wash. Second thing, so after you've done your pre-wash, a traditional method will then be to fill up these two big buckets of water and use one bucket as a dedicated rinse bucket that you will use to clean off your mitt. And then after you've cleaned it off, you'll go into your wash bucket to pick up more soap and suds and then go back and clean your car. You know, as you all know about the two bucket method, or most of you will. Now, that two bucket method also relies or generally will advise you to use these grit guards in your bucket. So I just want to talk about these things. First of all, for anyone new to detailing, these grit guards sit in the bottom of your bucket, and the theory behind them is these fins on the bottom stop and trap dirt in these little quarter sections and stop the dirt being all spun around and then sort of picked up as you dunk your mitt deep into that bucket. The meshing on the top is also a place where you can rub your mitt to free up the dirt and let it fall down to the bottom. So that's what they're for. Generally speaking, there's a few others on the market, but you have two main offerings on the market and they're patented. So they're patented, which means usually the price is controlled by the guys that own the patent or the company that make them and sell them, you know, that developed them. So they control the price, so there's a massive margin in these. I don't know the financials behind them. But you have two types. You have the scratch shield one and the grit guard one, okay? The grit guard one has fixed fins which do not come off, okay? So that means there is no changing of the fitment size of this. It's one size. So the important thing when you go for this option, and this is the better option to go for, is to make sure it fits well in your bucket. Because the more this moves inside your bucket, the more these fins are going to push the dirt that sits at the bottom of the bucket around and stir them up. So you want a good tight fit. That's important, okay? These ones are known as scratch shields. And the difference with these is the fins come off, so that you can adjust where you put the fin in. depending on the size of the bucket. So if it's a big bucket, you could put the fins in there, you know. If it's a small one, you put them all the way in there, which sounds kind of good on the face of it, because you can wedge this in and stop it moving. However, when you make contact, that says it all. When you make contact with these, with your mitt, and you move this meshing around, and you twist these, what happens is they fall out, okay? So a lot of people take to gluing them in. And I do not really think it's a good idea to be putting glue on these, because the more you work them, the more these twist and move, the more the glue will crumble away and end up in your mitt. Could scratch your car if it's the wrong type of glue. So I do not recommend these scratch shields. I recommend the grit guards. They're not cheap. I think they're about, the grit guards are at least a tenner, maybe more. Chemical Guys do another version that they've developed themselves with little cones, inverted cones in them. I don't know if that's any good or not. So that's the two bucket method. Generally a pre-wash, which isn't something, you know, it's just something you do as part of your routine. And then the two bucket method with a rinse bucket and a wash bucket and your grit guards in there, and generally big detailing buckets that are quite expensive, about 10 to 15 quid for these 20 litre buckets. Okay, so that's the two bucket method. If you're going to do a two bucket wash method, some people do this already, this isn't my idea, but this is a very good bit of advice. Put both your grit guards into your rinse bucket, okay? Because your wash bucket, you're just going in there to pick up product, okay? You don't need to go right to the bottom of your rinse bucket and move it all around the bottom. You can just go in the top and scoop up some more product and get some of those suds that are on the top. So you don't really need a grit guard in your wash bucket. So put two of these, if you ever do this method, into your rinse bucket, okay? I've also seen there's someone that's designed an angled kind of grit guard that clips on to the existing grit guard so that you can rub your mitt against it without going right to the bottom of the bucket and circulating it all over that dirt, which is probably quite a sensible thing actually. Okay, so my one bucket method involves using any bucket basically that's clean and doesn't have all this embedded dirt in there or any cracks in it. Any solid bucket's in good condition. These ones cost £1 from B&Q. You know, everyone's got one of these. This is a 10 litre bucket, okay? And no grit guards. So that's the first part of the equipment you'll need to do this one bucket method. The £1 bucket or 10 litre standard bucket. The next bit of equipment you'll need is one of these Chinese wash mitts that I keep banging on about, and I'll put a link in the description. You buy them on eBay, there's a million and one different vendors selling them. You recognise them because this bit's brown, you know. And they're called lamb's wool, but they're synthetic apparently. Okay, the reason I use these for this one bucket method is because of the size and because of the depth of the nap. That makes it easy to rinse this mitt out, and we'll talk about why that's important later on. I'd recommend you go and buy a ton of these because they're so cheap, like £1.20, £1.30. I'm not sure exactly what they are now, but they're dirt cheap. So yeah, the Chinese wash mitt. Okay, the next thing I want to talk about is shampoos. So you can use any shampoo you like for this method. It doesn't matter, you know. Whatever shampoo you're happy with. I'm going to be using Carchem 1900:1. So it's one of those concentrated shampoos. I like everything about this shampoo. I like the slip. So there's three characteristics, you know, that I rate my shampoos by. One is the amount of slip. You know, you can feel that slip under your mitt when you've got loads of the product, and you can feel it in your fingers. So I like a shampoo that's got a lot of slip in it. That's what I call it, lubrication, okay? I like shampoo that's got good cleaning power. So these, they've got chemicals in there, you know, I'm not sure they call them surfactants or whatever. You've got two different types. There's all the chemistry side of this, but the cleaner agent that's within the shampoo that actually does the cleaning. So how well the shampoo will affect the dirt that's on the car, okay? And the third thing is residue. How the shampoo, because there's a difference in how these residues come off the car. So you don't, obviously you want to be rinsing this product off your car before it dries, but some of them, they don't rinse off very easily. So that's the thing I keep an eye out for. So lubrication, cleaning power, and residue. And also, you know, the concentration, how they foam up, you know, you want, I like tons of suds on mine, and I like to see all that product. You know, I hate it when it's really thin, you've got hardly any product on there. I love loads of suds. I think we all do on that. So the Carchem one is great. I've got tons. I've always liked Meg's Gold. That's one that's been around for donkey's years. A couple of other ones. Lloyd's Auto Perfected one, which is another highly concentrated 2001. It's called Simply Shampoo. It's just a good concentrated shampoo. I've been using this for a while now. It's a nice one. And the AM Details one. I blind tested this a couple of years ago about a year ago for one of the PVD things. And this scored really highly. Again, it's a nice thick kind of gel like, you know, you see some of them that are not loose liquids, they're quite jelly. That foams up really well, comes off really well, and does the job well. So that's the AM Details Bubbles. I've just recommended a few good ones. I've got a ton of them over there, so I'm not too fussy with shampoos as long as they're not bad in any of those areas that I said, you know. Okay, another thing. Whenever you're doing this method, you should have one of these in your pocket. I've talked about before, a hog's hair brush. Interested, this is a low quality thing that was cheap and cheerful at Freebie, I think. Be interested to know if anyone knows of a good quality one of these. I've got Valet Pro ones and some others, but they all seem the same, which is not a great quality brush. I'm looking for a really soft, high quality brush that's still durable. So, interesting if anyone's got any recommendations on that. Okay, the next thing, as always, is you're going to need a method to dry your car. And, you know, I'm using a drying towel. So this is a twist. This is a Chinese twist drying towel that I'm used. I just flip them around. I try all sorts of different ones. I'm just testing the hell out of this one to see how it lasts. And it's starting to break down now, finally, after a few weeks of kind of intense use, which I thought it would. It's starting to untwist. So, yeah, you never know until you use them for a long time. But anyway, you're going to need a method to dry your car, so a drying towel. And then after you've dried it, a good rinse aid detail spray, okay? So three that I recommended in that PVD mega test, Adams Detailing Spray, which is a fantastic all-round, lovely smooth product, but it's one of those ones that melts water well and refuses to smear, so it works well as a drying aid as well. Although, again, all of these is just doing a bit of a disservice to say they're just rinse aid specialists, but they just behave well when there's still water on the car, so they're good recommendations. Adams Detailing Spray, which everyone knows about, it's very popular. The KKD Mist X, which I think is an SiO2 detailing spray. Again, it's got good water melting. I talked about it. It's just a good product as a rinse aid especially. And this one, which I really liked, really noticed the gloss on this. Really, is, you know, if it's gloss boosting polymers or whatever it's in there, really like the finish this gives you and the water melting. But out of all of them, this one just won't streak. You can't make this one streak. So it's a really good, it's a good detailing spray for using as a rinse aid. Infinity Wax RDS Rapid Detailer Spray. And with that, I'll be using a buffing cloth, but it's this Everest, this Ragmaster Everest that's 1100 GSM. So it's got a lot of absorption. So when you're using a detail spray and you've still got standing water left, so you want to soak some of that up as well as break it all down. A really nice, thick, heavy buffing cloth works well. So the Everest 1100. It's really safe. It's a Korean 70-30 blend, and it's just like air across your paint. It doesn't make a good cloth for buffing off polishes and waxes because it's just too soft. It doesn't have enough bite on it, but it's great for just buffing out detailer sprays when you're drying a car. So the Everest 1100. And finally, something that I've only just put in the mix as of this week, and well, about a week ago, is using about a quarter of a capful of this in a bucket, in a quarter of a capful to a gallon, so about 5 litres, half of that red, that orange bucket of Optimum No Rinse, ONR, because I love what this does to water. It just, it's almost like coating, it does something really weird to water. It almost like thins the water out and gives the water this real glistening kind of, it's almost like wrapping water in shining cling film. It's hard to explain, but you can see when you've got this in a product and you're using it, you can see something going on the clear coat. It's weird, but I like it. And it's, you notice the slip. So one of the best tips, I say it's optional, but I would have this in your arsenal because it's such a versatile product. Optimum No Rinse. You can get it from cleanyourcar.com. Clean Your Car, yeah. And I'll put a link for it in the description. It's good stuff. Okay, so that's all the kit you're going to need to do the one bucket wash method. You're also going to need your hose, okay? Free flowing water. And one of these, you know, you've all got one of these that clips onto your hose. This is a hose lock one, and it allows you to adjust the shaping of the water so you can mist it out, you can stream it out. You know, it's got horizontal kind of layered mist, etc. It's got low pressure tap. It's got like a watering can sprinkler. So I use this hose lock one, but you know, you'll have something similar. Okay, that's all the equipment. Okay, before I talk about going through what the one bucket wash method is, I want to talk about why don't I just do this normal two bucket rinse, get my pressure washer out and kind of, you know, do the approved normal method. So that's what I wanted to talk about in this section. Okay, the number one reason I don't always opt to do the full Monty kind of two bucket thing is just time, okay? So filling up that rinse bucket with like 15 litres of water, okay? And then filling up that wash bucket with you know, 10 litres of water, you know, it's a lot of water. And then you're also gonna be done a pre-wash on the car, and you're gonna be snow foaming, rinsing that all off, getting all that equipment out. And the main factor is when I wanna just wash a car, you know, a regular car that I'm not obsessed about, the Mrs. Golf, you know, if it's dirty once a week, it needs a clean. You want to keep it nice and shiny. I want to wash it in about 10 to maybe 15 minutes. I treat it as my workout rather than going for a run. I think, right, I'm going to wash the car, get some good exercise and get the old core moving and get a clean car. Much better than just running around like an old donkey. So that's the thing. I want it done in about 15 minutes. If the outside, you know, less. If I've got a bit of time on my hands and I'm messing around, then I'll tinker around doing bits of stupid things on there. But generally 15 minutes, half an hour max. When you're doing the full shebang with snow foaming, it becomes a bit of a, you know, getting the pressure washer out, it becomes a bit too much effort and a bit too much of a pain in the butt, if you know what I mean. Then you've got to put it all away at the end and you can end up taking an hour and a half just to clean your car. So that's the main reason why this one bucket method is what I turn to. It also has to be safe, by the way. I'm not going to just go out there and just do a butchering technique on my clear coat and rip it all up just to save time. So it's safe. But the main reason is the time and all the equipment that it takes to do this formal method, okay? There's also some weaknesses in this two bucket method, and I want to talk about those now. So the first weakness, and probably the most significant weakness in that two bucket method, imagine you've been out running and you've got covered in mud all over your face and in your hair, okay? And it all dries and you've got bits of mud, you can feel it all stuck in your hair. Now, if you wanted to clean that mud out your hair, would you go and dunk your hair in a bath full of muddy water? Because what will happen is some of the little bits of mud that are in there will get dissolved and fall out. But all the mud that's in there, in the water, will then just also rinse into your hair. And when you take your hair out, it's wet with dirty water. You're going to find you've got more dirt in there than you started with. What you're going to do if you've got mud in your hair is you're going to go and get a shower and run that shower over your head. And you're also probably going to put some shampoo in there as well and then rinse that shampoo away, okay? So we are cleaning our wash mitt. whole foundation of this thing is that we will actually be cleaning our wash mitt as we use it with the hose, okay? And we'll talk about how we do that a bit later on. When you start off and you've got a dirty mitt, you go into the rinse bucket, it's clean initially. It's just clean water, like 10, 15 litres. You go in and you move it around on the grit guard and you're shaking some of that dirt out of the towel, you're working it out, and then you bring it out, squeeze out all that dirt, and it's cleaner than it was before it went in there. But now what happens is you've got a kind of bucket which starts getting progressively more contaminated, the more dirt you put in there. Up to a certain point, it will get to a certain point, that bucket is so dirty that dunking the mitt in it to try and get the dirt out of it is not actually achieving much, and you're going to still be putting more dirt in than you're taking out, okay? So that's the first thing. You know, anyone who's done this method, you'll know by the end of it, your rinse bucket is generally pretty mank, okay? And that's not good, because if the rinse bucket is mank, that dirt is going in your mitt. Okay, the second thing I don't like about this method, okay? So you're supposed to put generally one grit guard in each bucket, okay? So we talked about what this grit guard does. So it's supposed to trap the dirt. These fins, you know, keep the dirt in still water down the bottom, okay? And then you put your mitt in and you rub the mitt over this grid and it frees up the dirt and it sinks down. The problem is when you're this close to the dirt at the bottom, okay, one thing is when all your water is brown, that means there's dirt in it, okay? And if it's brown at the top, there's dirt in the top. It takes a while for all the dirt to slowly sink down and settle into your bucket. Probably if you left the bucket, dirty bucket of water there for about half an hour, you would see lots of grit. But you need that grit to be out the way instantly, and it won't. It takes time to sink down. So more often than not, you are still hitting grit because it hasn't sunk to the bottom of the bucket. Also, when you put that mitt down the bottom, you rub it there, no matter how good this grit guard is, it moves, okay, and it shakes up a lot of the dirt and puts it into the mitt, in my opinion, okay? So washing your mitt in a dirty water is not great, okay? It's not awful, don't get me wrong, it's not awful. There's a good theory behind doing it. So you try and get most of the dirt out before you go into the rinse bucket. It does do that, okay? So but it's not perfect, okay? And I found that just from rinsing your mitt, you can get it a hell of a lot cleaner and virtually as quick than dunking it in a bucket full of water, okay, or dirty water in this case. So that's the most important thing. You'll have also seen that I'm not the only one that thinks that's a problem, because another company developed an add-on, a kind of clip-on wash mitt that clips onto the side of this and sits up here so that you can wash your mitt, rub it against it without having to go to the bottom of that bucket where you don't want to be. So it is a bit of a problem, especially, you know, it's just a method of working. You just follow the rules to give yourself better results. You know, it is all OCD, this is. There's no doubt about it. But there is some, you know, some thought behind why you should do things. And it's mainly because of the amount of effort it takes to get clear coat nice. When you've got it nice, you really want to keep it nice, you know. It's days of work to get it nice. Okay, so they are the main kind of reasons. The effort it takes to fill all those up, you know, the cost of those as well. Just to get two buckets like that with two grit guards in it like that, you're usually talking between 30 and 40 quid, you know, for good ones, which is a hell of a lot of money, considering that's going to cost you a quid. One other thing I'll just say, it's not a disadvantage of the two bucket method, but you get a lot of people kind of, again, like I said with the snow foaming video, suddenly people are kind of thinking that if they're snow foaming their car before they rinse it, then it's safe, everything's fine, they're snow foaming, they're getting everything off there, when what the actual reality is of what a pre-wash is doing is slightly different. There are reasons for doing it, as I said, you know, I'm not totally against pre-washing and snow foaming and stuff, it's all cool, but you have to know the limitations. What I see a lot with the two bucket method is people, again, getting two buckets and then just thinking, that's it. I just dunk that bucket in there before I dunk that bucket in there, and I'm doing the two bucket method. And the most important thing you can do if you're doing this two bucket method is nothing to do with dunking one there, dunking one there. The most important thing you can do is wring your mitt out really well before you go in that rinse bucket, okay? Then go in the rinse bucket, really working, try and get all that dirt and grit out of the mitt, and then really rinse it out properly before you go anywhere near that wash bucket. The amount of times I see people just plonk one into the, dunk it into the rinse bucket and then dunk it straight into the wash bucket. That's just absolute waste of time. You know, it's a complete waste of time if you're doing that. So yeah, use your common sense if you're doing the two bucket method and really make sure you try and get as much dirt out of that mitt before you rinse and after you rinse. Okay, so those are the main disadvantages of the two bucket method. It's the time, it's the cost of the equipment, it's the amount of water you're using, and it's the fact that to do with the flaw of you using a rinsing method where you're dunking your mitt in a progressively dirtier mix of dirt and water, basically, okay? So, the one bucket wash method. First thing we do, okay, is we mix up our bucket, our single bucket, no grit guard, make sure it's clean in here, okay? That's the name of the game, keeping this nice and clean and pure. I will use about half of this, so between 4 and 5 litres of water, okay? And I will use the normal dose that they say on the instructions per bucket. So with the Carchem one, it'd be 2 capfuls, and that'll be it. I'll put that product in first with no water, okay? I know a lot of the sort of professional details will tell you to put some water in first, then some product, and then sort of put the old pressure washer in and blast it up, which is great, but I'm not doing this with a pressure washer, and I find just activating the shampoo with the hose with on a stream is good enough, and it will get me all the foam that I need, okay? The only bad side of that is it's quite hard to measure how much water you've got in the bucket, but it doesn't have to be exact. So about halfway with water and loads of suds, and a 1/4 capful of ONR, that's really important. Okay, so you get your mix ready, put your mitt in there, get your brush in your pocket. Then the first thing to do is rinse your car, okay, with just low pressure water, however you like. If you want it on a stream, use a stream, you can target areas better. If you want to fan it out and just do it, but whatever you do, just cover your whole car in water. Get any bits of debris you can see, just give them a good soaking, you know, in those wheel arches, all common sense, just get it all nice and wet, okay? And that's our pre-wash, just a bit of water. Okay, so the next thing is then to start washing the car with the one bucket method. So you dunk your mitt at this stage is completely clean, okay? So you dunk it in there, or it's been soaking in there, and away you go. You go up to your car, always start at the top, you know, work your way down. So you clean your panel, and I'll cut to a section of me cleaning on the van. And then once you've done a panel or a section, okay, so that section could be where you're standing. For example, it could be the hood, and it could be the front door and window, it could be the roof, or start at the top, obviously. Once you've done that section, you have the hose in your other hand, you then rinse that shampoo off the car, okay? And that's optional. You could, normally when you shampoo, you do the whole car, don't you, with the two bucket method, and you rinse at the end. Well, if you've got the hose in your hand, it allows you to rinse off while you're doing it. And if you're working in the sun, that is a really good thing to do, because you can keep the car kind of wet and cool if you're working out in sunlight, which you want to avoid, but sometimes you can't, you know. So yeah, rinse that off. Then you take your mitt, you get your hose on a setting that's got as much pressure as you can muster, not a stream one, so nice fine kind of pressure spray. So my one's got a horizontal one, like a jet. And all I do is I just blast this mitt up and down, and then I rinse from the top so all the water falls through the mitt. And then I look at the mitt and make sure there isn't any grit there. And I'll show you and cut to the pictures. Whenever I've rinsed a mitt after a pass, I make sure that it is 100% clear, okay? Okay, so after you've cleaned your mitt out and you're satisfied, the mitt is just as clean as it was when you started, you go back in your bucket. Don't go back in your bucket if you've got any bits or stuff in the mitt. Just keep soaking it and it flushes it all out, okay? So you're looking for a really clean mitt. That is the secret thing. Sorry, that's the key thing, is that every time this mitt is loaded up with product and touches your car, it doesn't, when you start that pass, it doesn't have any grit on it from the previous pass. That is the most important thing about this method, okay? So yeah, you rinse down, clean your mitt, load up the product and go again. So generally I'll kind of work a panel at a time. If I do the roof, I'll do that half of the roof, you know, if it's a small car, and then come down and do that top section where the windows are, then stop, clean off, load up, go again on that kind of door. You know, generally they say you leave the bottom of the car, if it's really loaded up with dirt, till the end, you know, under near all where all the skirts are. Well, you've got to use your common sense here and have a look at the car and see how dirty it is. But what I find is, even if you get this mitt loaded up with dirt because you hit some really nasty stuff, you still hit it with that pressure washer. It's something to do with the way this thing is short pile. You can get all of the dirt out of this mitt without too many problems. Some of the other mitts, where are they? Like this one, for example. Lovely and soft on paintwork, really deep, kind of long pile. But the problem is, when the grit gets in here, it gets so stuck in here, okay? Now, I know if it's deeper down, it's more away from your paintwork, but still, when you get a build-up of it, you can see it. When you're pushing this on your paint, you still might be dragging that grit, and it doesn't take a lot to scratch your car. Whereas with that short one, you can flush all of the dirt out of it, and you just go back in, you have a look at it, and you know there's nothing there, so you're not going to scratch your car, okay? So, don't get me wrong, this is great for other methods, but this rinse method, I wouldn't use one with, you know, a real deep pile on it, because like I say, it's harder to rinse out there and then. Something like this, the microfiber one that's a bit shorter pile, will work a lot better on this type of method. Okay, so that you finish off your entire car doing that basic method, wash, rinse the mitt till it's completely clean, go again, work your way around your car, okay? You've got the hose in your hand, so if you're out in the sunlight, you know, you can just use that hose as you like to keep the car wet and cool. Do not let that water dry on your car. That's one of the key things in the summer. That's why this method's really cool in the summer as well, actually. When you finish the car, if you want, you can then go ahead and do your wheels. And at the stage where you do your wheels, you can kiss goodbye to keeping the mitt clean, okay? Although, it's not too bad. You can still get a lot of it out. It's if you hit greasy dirt, you know, the stuff that's on the tire, that dirt fallout all mixed in with silicon, that will blacken your mitt very quickly. You know, wheels and wheel arches will do it. But you finish with your paintwork at that stage, so then you can sacrifice your mitt. You can sacrifice keeping your bucket clean and just go commando on your wheels. Obviously, if you've got high-end wheels and you're trying to keep the wheels in good nick, okay, then you can be a little bit more careful. Get your wheels done, get the faces of your wheels done first, or get your wheel brushes out, you know, and use a separate bucket. You can treat the wheels however you like. I generally, because I keep my wheel reasonably good, if I keep cleaning regularly, all I really need to do is get that hose and that shampoo and just keep rubbing all around it and get all the wheel and the barrels done first. And then I'll go around all four and do that. And then I might just do a quick scoop of the arches. And at that stage, the mitt will get filthy. So we're kind of done at that point. Okay, so those are all the steps to the one bucket wash method. So this is our wash bucket at the end. So I just wanted to show you how clean this water is, okay? Now there is dirt in here, okay? It's not 100% clean. At the end of the day, we're cleaning the car with it. So, you know, even though we're taking a lot of care to get our mitt, you know, minimize the amount of dirt, there is some dirt in here. You probably can't see it on the camera, but it's very clean. And the reason it's very clean is because before the mitt goes in here, it gets rinsed off, okay? That is the reason this water is very clean.
Now, if I'd have been using a two bucket wash method, this bucket would be dirtier than it is now. And that's something that I've learned. No matter how careful I am, if I'm dunking into one bucket here, then going across to this bucket, I'm putting a lot more dirty water into this bucket than I am if I rinse it off using fresh water running through like a shower from the hose. So very clean water.
So what are the pros and cons of the one bucket wash method? So the first pro, you generally, even though you're doing a lot more rinsing, you use less water in my opinion. I think it might be close, but because you're starting off with 5 liters in your wash bucket versus maybe up to 30 liters, 15 in each, or 10 to 15 in one and probably 10 to 15 in the other. So somewhere between 20 and 30 liters. So straight away, you're up about 15 to 25 litres, you're ahead. So you're probably going to use a lot of that when you're rinsing, although you still got to rinse with that method. So generally you're going to use a lot less water, okay? Generally as well, you'll use less shampoo, because if you're filling that up with 10 to 15 litres of water, the more water you use, the more shampoo you've got to put in to get a good mix and a good concentration, okay? More of the product, because you're using kind of like quite a high concentration of product in mixed in with 5 liters, the end result is you get most of that product on your car, okay? So I use a really quite heavy mix with lots of foam, lots of froth, and I really pile that on. That's just that's a personal preference. I think most people like to do it that way though. The next advantage is the cost of the equipment doing it this way, using the cheap Chinese mitt, which is great for this, using the £1 method, using that concentrated shampoo which will last you forever. So far we're talking £1 for the bucket, £1.20 for the mitt. Drying towel, you can use what you like, you know, a little bit of ONR to give you that extra protection. The cost is going to be less, you know, less from a kind of using electric and you know utilities and water and all that stuff when you've got the pressure washer out. It's cheaper. You get where I'm going, but the main thing is the buckets, because those buckets cost an arm and a leg. Okay, the biggest pro is the time saver. I can get a car cleaned so quickly. You know, I could be halfway around the car while I'm still would be filling up the buckets with the other method. So I can't emphasize, this is so much quicker to just fill up your mix, out there you go with your hose and your mitt ready to go, and blast your car down. Okay, and the last pro is that I have done the two bucket method so many times now, and from doing this one bucket method for probably over a year now, I can tell you, since rediscovering those Chinese mitts, the mitt is a lot cleaner. You're really more paying more attention to the mitt because you're cleaning it there right in front of you. And when you're doing your rinse out and your rinse through, you kind of really have a good control over that. And you know you've flushed all of that dirt out of the mitt. Whereas when you're dunking it in the bucket, you tend to not pay as much attention to it. And there's more dirt in there that you can't see within that dirty water, in my opinion. So that's another pro. So what are the cons? The main con is you lose a hand, because you're holding the hose, which is a bit of a pain in the ass, dragging the hose around with you. But you haven't got to drag two 15 litres of water in two buckets and keep shifting those along, you know, or pay for those wheelie things. You know, I'm into detailing, but I'm not paying 30 odd quid for a little plastic wheelie thing so I can wheel my buckets around in them. Hell no. So yeah, you just got one bucket and a hose to move around. That's the only con as far as I can see. But this is where you guys come in, because, you know, could you think of any other cons as to this method? I'd like you to try it using that wash mitt, that I talk about, because I can't really see any disadvantages, to be honest. Especially in terms, because I've been doing it a while now, especially in terms of the finish, mainly on that Golf. You know, that Golf is it's not battered, but it's just a car I don't care about, because she reverses into too many things for me to care about the car. You know, there's another scratch on the wing, you know. Jesus, women can't drive, and it's not going to make me too popular, but it's true, isn't it? They can't reverse. So you don't give them a car with immaculate paint that you're worried about, because they're just going to reverse in or something. Yeah, and the alloys as well. Jesus Christ. Yeah, you get the alloys done. The next day, she'll have them ground down to the size of a polo mint. So yeah, but I keep an eye on the paint on that Golf because I use it as a bit of a test mule, and it doesn't have any swirls on it. And I've been doing this one bucket method for ages. I also think the inclusion of the ONR into the rinse bucket is also really going to add to this. And I think that's something you should do too, even if you don't like this method and you kind of stick to the two bucket one. Get some ONR and put it in there. You'll love that. Okay. So as with any cleaning method, once you finish, you can give your car a final rinse down if you like. Dry it then with your drying towel and go over with your quick detailing spray and your buffing cloth of choice. So in this video, we're going to be using the Everest 110 because it's a nice, soft, ultra-absorbent pillow of a towel. I quite like for buffing, for quick detail and finishing, I quite like it, okay, because of all the absorbency. So this was just a quick video, although when I cut it together, it'll probably be like all the other ones and bang on for hours and hours. And I just wanted to show you how the method that I generally use to keep my vehicles clean under certain conditions. So, like I say, don't get me wrong, I'm not sort of, voice is going after this talking. I'm not anti the two bucket method. The method works, okay, in the way that the fact that most of that dirt is in your rinse bucket rather than your shampoo bucket is kind of a cool thing. However, the idea of washing your, I know I've said this hundreds of times throughout the video, the idea of using that progressively dirtier and dirtier mix of dirt and water to clean off your mitt is not a great idea for me. I just find it too much effort to do that when I can get the mitt cleaner with a hose. Now, again, if I'm working on a car that is high end, which doesn't happen that often now, you know, I don't do this professionally, but if I've done paint correction on the car, if it's one of mine or a friend's, and it's a lot of work's gone into it, then snow foaming first, you know, to get that dirt off in the safest possible way, and using that two bucket method is still probably gonna be, if you really take the time, because it's ultimately it's about getting that mitt clean, getting the product on it, and then getting that dirt off with a very, you know, you've got to cover the car, but you don't obviously want to go in heavy handed, you know. So that's the most important thing, is how you actually handle the kind of mitt and the car and make sure you've got all that product loaded up. But this is like the kind of, you know, the fundamentals, it's the background principles that are going to help you actually do that job more effectively by sort of managing the way that you get rid of the dirt off of the car. You know, it is the more you think about this, some people would look at detail and just think, hey, it's just off your rocker doing all this. But the thing is, if you don't do it and you don't wash your car with consideration, you don't wash your car with consideration, you know what happens. Your paintwork looks rubbish. And there's nothing worse than a really nice car that looks dead because the finish has just had all of the shine scratched out of it from not even years. It can be months of really bad cleaning. And on the flip side to that, you also don't want to be one of the guys that is employing all of these detailing methods and covering his car in snow foam and using two buckets that still has bad paintwork because he's not doing everything properly, okay? And it's very easy to get all the right equipment but still do it incorrectly. And you've got to be careful when you say that because you'd end up sounding like patronizing, you know. This is all about fun and enjoyment, but it's all about washing the car properly. Okay, so just think about kind of what you're doing is the advice I always try and give when you're doing anything detailing, and especially when it's a cleaning duty on paintwork. That's one of the most important things. So yeah, this has just been a quick video on the way I typically clean my cars if I want to do it quickly and safely with minimal equipment and minimal fuss. I'm really interested in your opinions on this. I've got a feeling a lot of people will not really like this and not really want to do this and be more happy using two buckets, you know, pre-washes and all the formal methods all of the time. And you know what, I can understand that. And I think if I had in sitting in my garage, you know, a Ferrari with immaculate paint, I would follow the formal methods. But for the missus's golf, for my workhorse van, you know, they get the one bucket method treatment for sure, and it works pretty good for doing what I need it to do. So thank you very much for tuning in to the Forensics Detailing channel as always. We will be doing the M3 polish. We will be doing it this week. It's just time, as always, just finding the time. But the next video, I think, will be this one. So I'm really looking forward to that, and I'll see you next time on the channel.